Hey guys, I am Venkat and this is part 26 of Web Development with Blazor video series. In this video, we'll discuss DataGrid templates in ASP.NET Core Blazor. Templates give you a great control over the rendered HTML. Sync Fusion Blazor DataGrid is highly customizable. It's a templated component, which means we can customize various parts of the DataGrid UI to render custom components or content based on application requirements and our own logic. The following are the different types of DataGrid templates: column template, header template, row template, and detail template. Now, here is what we want to be able to do. Display employee image in one of the DataGrid columns as shown right here. If you want to follow along, I already have all these images uploaded onto my blog and you can download them from there. I'll include the link to my blog in the description box below this video. At the moment, in our Blazor client project, inside this www root folder, we don't have images folder. So let's add a new folder, name it images. We want to store all these employee images in the images folder in www root folder so we can serve them up to the Blazor component. So let's cut them from here and then paste them in the images folder. Now, here's the important bit. Notice the names of the images. We have numbers. The name of each employee image is their respective employee ID, as employee IDs are unique. You can use your own naming strategy, but using employee ID is better for two reasons. Employee IDs are unique, so even if there are two employees with the same name, the possibility of accidentally overwriting employee images is reduced. The code to display employee image becomes much easier, as employee ID is part of employee entity and available in the data grid. We'll see this code in just a bit. At the moment, in employees database table, this photopath column is null. We want to update this to include each employee's photopath. And we know employee photos are present in the images folder. So let's include a simple update statement. Update employees set photopath equals, we know all employee photos are present in the images folder, and to this we want to append employee ID, which we can retrieve from the employee ID column, and to this we want to append the image extension. In our case, it is PNG, and if we execute this query now, we get an error, and that's because it's trying to convert this string images to integer. We actually want to do the opposite. We want to convert this employee ID integer column to string. So for that, let's use SQL Server cast function. We want to cast employee ID as a string. Execute the query, select the data again. There we go, photopath column updated as expected. In the interest of time, here's what I've done already in the background. In the pages folder, I included this new component, datagridtemplates.razor, which is right here. And in this component, we have a Sync Fusion data grid, and these are the grid columns that we are displaying at the moment: employee ID, first name, last name, date of birth, etc. So if we take a look at this page in the browser, we see the employee details as expected. And here's what we want to be able to do. Just before this ID column, we want to include photo column and then display each employee photo. Now, this is the grid column that displays employee ID. Just before this column, we want another grid column. We have set header text to photo, center align, and width to 120. Inside this grid column, we want a column template. And for that, we use template component. Inside this, we can include any custom content we want based on our application requirements. In our case, we want to include an image element and render each employee image. Remember, inside the data grid, we have access to an implicit parameter called context, and we can typecast that to employee type. Let's store this in a variable, name it employee. All that is left to do is include an image element and bind the source attribute to employee variable dot photopath property. As a good practice, let's also set the alternate text to employee photo. Close the image tag, save the changes, and take a look at the browser. We have the employee photos displayed, but as you can see, the photos are too big. So let's specify height and width for the image element that we are rendering. Just below the data grid, let's include style element. Type equals text slash CSS. and we want to include a CSS class. Let's name it thumbnail. Let's set height to 80 pixels and width also to 80 pixels. And then we want to specify this as the CSS class for our image element. There we go. We have employee images displayed as expected. At the moment, each employee image is rendered as a square. If you want a circle, all we need to do is set this tile, border radius. Let's set it to 40 pixels. There we go. We now have a circle instead of a square. At the moment, what we are using here is a column template. We use a column template to customize the content that we have in a specific data grid column. But what if I want to customize the data grid header? Well, we use header template. Now, here's what we want to be able to do. Next to the header text in gender column, we want to display a custom image. As usual, first, let's cut this image from here and paste it in the images folder. Next, inside this gender grid column, we want header template. Inside the header template, include a div element, and then we want the text gender. Next to that, we want to render an image element. Set the source attribute to images / gender icon dot png. Let's also set the image height and width using the style attribute. As a best practice, we can use a CSS class. I will leave that as an exercise for you. So let's set height to 20 pixels and width also to 20 pixels. And then finally, alt text. We don't see the image. Why is that? Well, that's because we're using this character tilde in the path. We don't need this. There we go. We now see our custom image displayed in the DataGrid header. In this video, we discussed column and header templates. We use column template to customize grid column cell content and header template to customize grid column header cell content. In our next video, we'll discuss row and detail templates. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.